गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम टू द कंप्यूटर क्लास. दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4, मोर ऑन एमएस एक्सेस. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट क्वेरीज एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेरीज. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो माय फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज क्वेरी. सो चिल्ड्रेन, क्वेरी means can either be request for data result from your database, or it is the action on the data, or for both. Or simply a query can give you an answer to a simple questions. Okay, it's perform calculations, combinations, data from a different tables. Okay, suppose add, change or delete data from a database. Now similarly, Microsoft Access or MS Access 2010 is a database management system which has the capability of answering question asked by the user with the help of query. Okay, so now the question is, how many types of queries are used in MS Access? So basically there are mainly three types of query are used in MS Access. First one is simple query, second is unmatched, and third one is duplicate query. Okay, so first one is simple query. Simple query means it is used to ask some particular questions, okay, about data in the database. Unmatched query, it means it is used to find the record from one table that data does not have corresponding value in the second table. Okay, suppose that here we use one data name is name. This is the one field. Okay, and here we type some name, suppose that X. This is the table number 1. Okay, this is the table number 2. Okay, but here this name X, record of X is not available in this table. Okay, so here we use unmatched query. So unmatched query means it is used to find the record from one table data that does not have corresponding value in the second table. Okay, now the duplicate query, it means it is used to display the record that have same value from one or more of the specified fields. Okay, so now the question is how to create a queries in MS Access. Okay, so to create a queries in MS Access, we can follow some steps. Open Microsoft Database or MS Access. Okay, step number 2, click on create tab option. Okay, look at this option here. Click on create tab option. This is the step number 2. Now in step number 3, click on query design in queries window. Okay, the show table dialogs box will appear, look like this. Okay, now in step number 4, click on the table that contain the information that we want to use in our queries. Okay, and in step number 5, click on this option, means add options. Okay, so a box will appear displaying the field for the table you have selected. In step number 6, repeat the step 4 and 5 to add each table for the queries. And step number 7, click on the close option. Okay, here. Now in step number 8, double click on a field which you want to include in your queries. Okay, for example, field name, table name. Okay, these are queries area. Okay, finally in step number 9, repeat step 8 to include each record or field which we want to include in your queries. Suppose that field name of student. Suppose that I am including the name of students, address, roll number. Okay, add some fields. Okay. Now the question is, yes, using some criteria. Yes, criteria means, so we can use a criteria to find a specific record in a database with the help of queries. So criteria are the condition. Criteria means this is the simple condition to identify the record from the database that you want to find. Okay, so here we use some steps for find the data from the database. So simply open the queries in design view, then click on criteria field. Now the type data that you want to view, and then click on view button. Okay, so this is the simply four steps to find the data. Okay, so criteria are the simply conditions to identify the record from the database that we have to find that. Okay, now we use some comparison operator, okay, to find the data from the database. Okay, so if we do not specify any comparison operator, MS access, assume that the criteria we have entered involve qualities. Okay, so there are some common operators we can use: greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Okay, so these are the some common comparisons operator. Okay, now the final step is how to save a queries in MS Access. Okay, so we can follow some steps for saving a queries in MS Access. So step number one, click on the file tab option here. Okay, then click on save or save as option, then enter the file name for queries in the query name text box, then click on OK button. Look at this picture. Okay, so here we type the query name, okay, or file name, then click on OK button, and finally click on close button. The database windows will appear and the data will save. Okay, so this is the last part of this chapter. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.